You see, our nature will always want to fill up free space in our life with some kind of mindless activity just so that we don't discover the scary truth. My name is Artemis and I welcome you to this channel. This is a space for anybody who's looking to reinvent their life. If you're new to this channel, please check out some of the other content. Let me know how you like it. If you totally hate my videos, please find that thumbs down button below and click that. Let me know why you hated it. But if you like them, and I hope you like them, I hope that they can do something for you. I hope that they can motivate you to start making positive changes in your life. One of the first positive changes that you can make is share this video with somebody who needs it. I've been taking a lot of trains lately, going back and forth. I like trains. Trains are an opportunity to sit back and kind of watch the surroundings. There's so many people on these trains. People come and go, get on stations, get off at different stations. And I enjoy watching people. Kinds of people on the train. Some are happy, some are sad, crying, laughing, screaming at somebody on the phone, being all romantic on the phone. It's a pretty amazing sight. So when I watch the people on the train, there's so many different patterns of behavior. I don't want to talk about the stereotypical, everybody's on their phone. I don't know what they're doing on the phone. But here's what I don't see many people doing is taking advantage of the time that they have sitting on the train to look inside themselves, spend some time in self-discovery. I see people in entertainment. I see people doing mindless activities. You see, self-discovery is about inspecting our own heart, inspecting our life. And the more areas in our life that we can inspect, the more we can cleanse them and get rid of things that we don't need. So many things in our daily life that we do habitually without ever questioning why. Self-discovery is about taking a purposeful look into our habits, into why we believe what we believe. Not only do we have these habits that shouldn't be acceptable in our lives, but we validate them. We say like, well, that's just the way I am.
Everybody does that.
You know, the more you feed those habits, the farther you are from getting rid of them, right? So whenever you start asking yourself questions, you get one step closer to finding out whether what you're doing is what you need to be doing. Basically, it boils down to finding out what your limitations are and looking for ways to find freedom. Reinventing is the journey of becoming freer. It is freer, by the way, not more free. You can look it up. So basically you're freeing up space in your life, but the problem with our human nature is whenever we get rid of something, we free up space. And that free space, it gets immediately refilled with something. And that's not gonna be anything active by itself, it's gonna be something passive. See, our nature will always want to fill up free space in our life with some kind of mindless activity just so that we don't discover the scary truth that all of our limitations, fears, desires, lusts, insecurities, and so on, they're only there to silence the voice of God in our heart. You start making positive changes in your life for the sake of changing something, then it's an exercise in futility, and it is a time bomb because your nature will always fight against that change and want to change it back to something passive and something negative.
All right, I know that was pretty confusing. Let me break it down.
there is a simple way, there's a hard way, and there's a right way, right? The simple way is not to ask any questions, just drift through life. I'm not saying it's gonna be a good life, I'm just saying that's the simple way. The hard way is to do it on your own and try to be the best you and try to be the new you in every new year and new opportunity. But you're bound to burn out and then you're gonna feel guilty and you don't know how far you can take it. The smart way is to ask the right questions first. One very important question that we have to continually be asking ourselves: am I ready to find out what God thinks about what I'm doing with my life? Whenever we find the truth, it leaves us with two options: to deny it or to run with it. So whatever that truth is, I hope that you can run with it, because denying the truth it doesn't make for a good living. Whatever you discover about yourself, whatever you discover about God, you have to run with it. You have to go for it. Denying the truth is not gonna lead to anything good in your life.